Welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. And in this video, I'm excited to show you how now we can take advantage that the C-Star ZWO has now allowed ASCOM Alpaca native support, which means we should be able to fully automate, fully control the C-Star through different astronomy apps. This will be very useful and I will show you why. But some of these apps include, for instance, Nina. A lot of people are already using that if you have Windows. Another app that I want to try firsthand right now is Sky Safari 7 Pro. Let's see if we can use this app to control, fully control the C-Star. It has a lot of advantages. And we will still be using the C-Star ZWO app that's native to C-Star, but this Sky Safari 7 Pro has a lot of functionality, and let's see if this is going to work. Let's do a hands-on step-by-step, and let's go. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is download Sky Safari 7 Pro from the App Store. And that's what I'm doing right now. So as soon as it's done, let's open it up. Okay, so I have downloaded Sky Safari Pro. Now you want to make sure, of course, that your C-Star is connected first to your C-Star native app. So let me go ahead and do that. Okay, so as you can see there, my C-Star is connected. I'm going to go ahead and just open ARM. Now I am doing this on the S50 for demonstration purposes, but do note that this should also work for your S30. And it should be pretty much the same process, but for this video, I'll be doing the S50. Okay, let's figure this out. So I'm gonna go to settings in Sky Safari Pro. I went ahead and changed my 12-hour clock, or my clock instead of 24 hours. I did the 12-hour AM, PM. That's up to you, that's your choice. I also changed the date format to month, day, and year. You can play around and tweak that as you'd like, but that's just my own personal preference. Now I'm going to go to presets. Auto discovery says, it says here, add device. And as you can see, you can connect several different telescopes to Sky Safari Pro, even Celestron. Now, do note that this app is specifically for iOS, specifically for your tablet, such as your iPad, and for your phone, for your iPhones. So I'm doing this on a Mac Studio right now. So, but it should work also. It's designed specifically for your phone and tablet, but this also works, as you can see, on any Mac that runs M1 chip or higher. You can download this app as well. Okay, let's do other, choose a telescope and connection. We're going to configure our own here. Alt Azimuth, go to. I have mine not on equatorial mode right now. Alt Azimuth, go to, and then I'm going to choose, C-Star will not be in here, ZWO C-Star, so the one that's compatible with C-Star S50 will be the LX200. So let's look for that one. Need LX200 Classic. Next. IP address. This was automated here for mine. So 10.0.0.1, port number 4030. Let's check the connection. Okay. So the reason why it didn't work is because I need to connect to the C-Star's internal Wi-Fi. So you want to make sure that you are not on station mode. I am actually connected directly under your Wi-Fi networks. You want it to show up as the S50, not on your Wi-Fi. And I'm talking about on your device, on your Mac computer. You want to make sure, or your iPhone or your iPad, you want to make sure the network of your Wi-Fi is not your home network, but your S50 network. So just make sure you're on that. Because now it worked. It says connection verified. Next. I'm going to change the name of this preset. It says Med LX200 Classic, which is what we chose, but we're going to name it C-Star S50. Save the preset. Use this preset. Okay, let me exit this. Okay, you see now the scope icon right here in the center. I'm going to click on that. I'm going to click on connect. It says it's connected. It has the slew rate. I'm going to keep it on the default. Okay, let's try to go to an object. It's working. This is really working. It's going to try to find Pluto. But of course, I have my C star indoors right now, but we're just testing to make sure that it works. This is pretty awesome. Now let's try to have the C star field of view in here. And I'm going to try to figure out if we can zoom into this as well. Click on observe. Click on scope display. I want the crosshairs. I'm going to leave that on as default. Oh, you can have Telrad circles too. That's kind of cool. I want to turn that on too. Custom field of view. Display name, C star. And I entered 0.7 by 1.3. And you see it actually popped up. Let me try to zoom into that. So these arrows here, I can manually move the C star. I can slew it. You see that, how it's moving? Either direction, you can go left, right, up and down. Okay, great. We can zoom in. Now you can also turn on cardinal directions, draw labels, show even if not connected to the telescope. Now, something that I recommend is for you to actually just use your regular native app, your C star app, to do your go-to, to look for objects and go to them from there. While you are in your stargazing mode, for instance, while you are looking at a nebula or a galaxy or a planet, then use your Sky Safari Pro as just like a secondary screen to be able to see what it's looking at and where in the night sky or what cardinal points it's at. So check it out. You can even turn on night vision, because remember, this is also for your iPhone and your iPad. So if you're outside and you don't want it to disrupt your vision, you can turn this, toggle this on and off. You can see you can click on the info as well, so you can get information on your object that you are looking at. So just to give you an example how this actually worked the other way around regardless, I went to Andromeda Galaxy, and if you look at my C star, if I turn this part off so just you can see, my C star went directly to Andromeda. The Sky Atlas just opened up to Andromeda. So let's do a different one here. I'm going to choose another object. So I'm going to click on the search feature. Let's heart nebula and let's click on go to. So let's look at the C star. Yes, it jumped to it. It just jumped to it. It looks like it can work either way, but let's try it now the other way. I'm going to go to an object now, a different object here. Let's go back to Andromeda and let's see what the Sky Safari Pro does and see if it'll show me going to it, Andromeda. So locate target. And then I'm going to click on go to. Skip that because it's just in my room. I'm just testing this. It worked. Yep, it's going to Andromeda here. If you want to be able to use the internet on your phone or tablet or your Mac computer, right? While you're using this Sky Safari Pro app, this is what you have to do. It has to do with your IP address of your C star. I promise this is very, very simple, okay? Nothing complicated about it. Menu, I'm going to go to settings. You're going to go to presets. And if you notice, it's actually this one. So I created a new one with the actual IP address of my C star. My native app is connected. My native C star app is connected to station mode. And you're going to have to find the IP address of your C star. And you can do that by going to a web browser, typing in your IP address. and sign in with your username and password. Another way you can find out your IP address is by going under your advanced features in your CSTAR. So under advanced features, you're going to get the telephoto RTSP address. Click on get, and it's going to be just the 192. It's going to be just the first 9 numbers. Don't use any letters or forward slashes. You're going to grab the first 9 numbers that you see there, just the first 9, typed in exactly as it says it there. Throw that into your Sky Safari Pro, right where it said to enter the IP address. Now, something to keep in mind is that this Sky Safari Pro 7, like I mentioned, is only for iOS devices, only for Mac, only for iPhone or your iPad. And also, Sky Safari Pro is $12.99. Now, it might seem like annoying to have to pay $12.99, but at the end of the day, to be honest, it's not, because it's not a monthly fee or anything like that. It's not a subscription. You just pay it one time, $12.99, and you're done with it. And also, I wanted to mention, I am in no way sponsored to bring this to you. I did this on my own. And for those of you that are on Windows, there are other options available, which would be, many are using Neenum, and many are using also Stellarium and others, and those work just as well. If you find this content valuable, make sure you hit the like button and make sure you subscribe if it's the first time to the channel, or if you've been coming for a long time and still haven't subscribed. I believe that over 60% of the viewers that come back to this channel over and over again are not subscribed. So make sure you hit the subscribe button. Okay, I'm back here to show you now how to get the rectangular of the CSTAR that you see on your Sky Atlas. And that way you'll know how much of your object is going to come out when you're stacking and when you're stargazing. If you notice, I was showing a circular field of view, but let me show you how to put together the rectangular exact field of view of the CSTAR. Once again, it's very simple. What you're gonna do is click on observe, and then you're gonna click on scope display. And if you had a different one on before, just turn and toggle them off, whatever you had before, which was a circular one. Just toggle that off. And you're gonna make a new one. I'll show you how to make a new one. You're gonna put create field of view, and you're gonna click on rectangular field of view. Okay? When you do the rectangular field of view, let me show you what you're gonna put in there. You're gonna put 0.70, 1.30. 0.70 by 1.30, display name CSTAR. You can also change the indicator color. You can make that a different color, which is kind of cool. Field rotation angle, you want this at 90. You can leave it at 0 if you'd like, but I'm gonna put it at 90. Because if you put it at 0, it's actually gonna be similar to your Sky Atlas in your CSTAR. So it's up to you. I'm gonna put it on 90, like I said. Field orientation, I've kept it at default. And then that's it. And then you notice your rectangular came up on there, right? Turned it off. The old one I had was circular. Might have been this one. But I'm gonna keep this one on. It'll stay on. You can take off the crosshairs, keep them. I'm gonna leave them all on. And that's it.